I got time to bleed. He ruined 8-bit hits.
Let's do it.
Done.
Hey.
Attention.
Hey there.
Huh? Don't have no handout.
You looking to
stock up on general equipment.
Chess, sometimes you need to sacrifice a piece to keep the game going. Keep that in mind.
Hey there.
We didn't get to the top of this town by playing fair. I could have handled it.
Yeah, but it's better if people know I can still get my hands.
Wake up, Commonwealth.
Besides, it wasn't personal. No need to torture the guy.
Since they're not your enemy, they are victims in this war as well.
They're always keeping from having fun.
Get that rifle.
But I'm a lover and a fighter.
Heads up. Hold position.
Magnolia, flower of the third rail. Anything you want to know about her other than that, her business. Now, you gonna hold?
The third rail. Is this your place?
What? Nah, go. Place is Hancock's. Oh, Charlie just keeps the floor clean. The drink's dirty. So, you buying or what?
So Hancock's the owner?
That's right. Owner and mayor of this whole bloody town. Trust me, never get on his bad side. Stay clear of his bodyguard. So, what's your poison?
Hancock has a bodyguard?
Yeah. Redhead with a condescending stare. Trust me, Cove, something about her ain't right. I'll never admit saying that. I'm trying to sell drinks here. You in?
What's the word around town?
Well, they say there's a newcomer around here who doesn't understand that I'm a bartender, not a damn goosebump. Now, are you gonna drink?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Nothing watered down. I need a dirty boy to do some dirty, dirty work. Blood on the pavement, bodies in the ground, that kind of thing. Interested?
I might be.
I got a certain anonymous client who's paying top dollar for a clean-up job. Three locations. Everyone inside. No witnesses. Only catch? It's all in town. The old warehouse, so I can't use my regulars. Too noticeable. That's where you come in. The job's 200 caps. Payment after it's done. Don't worry. I'll know what it is.
I don't do work unless I know who's paying the bills.
Oh, yeah, that would be me. I forgot about that one.
Well, looks like the man himself will be helping you. So, want this job or what?
Three locations? That's a lot of time. A lot of bullets.
Well, I guess we can sweeten the pot a bit. 250.
I'll get it done.
You better. Go out there and bust some
heads. We're often imitated, but we're never duplicated.
Follow me. Hold position. Hey. Hold up a sec.
Hold up a sec.
Hey there, Boston. It's Vinny. Here's Connie Francis' hip song, Everybody's Somebody's Fool. Ain't that the truth?
Your favorite DJ Vinny, and you're listening to Malt Shop Mayhem here in Boston.
One summer night, we fell in love. One summer night, I held you tight, you. Summer night, I held you close, you and I, under the moon of love. You kissed me, oh so tenderly, and I knew
I'd do the same if I had as much trouble.
Losing taste.
You're listening to Malt Shop Mayhem, and I am your cool, hip DJ Vinny. I'm playing the best Malt Shop hits for you all the time, anytime. All right. Here's Dion coming at you with a great hit, Run Around Sue. Why you always gotta be running around, Sue? What's your problem?
Here's my story, it's sad but true. It's about a girl that I once knew. She took my love, then ran around with every single guy in town.
Hey, hey, whoa!
here's another great song for you people of the Commonwealth.
Downstairs. Don't bother the other patrons.
I've heard some exterminator cleaned out the rats in the old warehouses. Wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Just doing my job.
Always appreciate doing business with a professional.
Trying to stay on good behavior here. Don't make me do something I'll regret.
Follow me. Hold position.
You're blocking my light, man.
Got the memory pod loaded up? Oh, you're not Irma.
Excuse me.
Good neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse. Sometimes you just got to escape a little to make it through the day.
I hear you. It's a mess out there.
It's rough in the best of days. But now, you ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's what we need. No matter how bleak things got, he saved the day.
My family and I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up.
Oh man, that's amazing! You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
Wasn't he a caveman?
Yeah, that's the one. They found him in an iceberg off the harbor. Boy, if you just woke up. The world these days must take some getting used to.
How did you get used to everything?
Mainly I focused on survival. It got real bad after the bombs fell. For a long while, I tried not to think of the good old days. Just too painful. But it's all we got now. So we gotta try and make it better. I got a question for you. What if the Silver Shroud was real? With his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life. So he can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
What plan?
I've built my own custom machine gun. Even better than the one in the show. But to make this work, I still need the most important piece. the genuine Silver Shroud costume herself. And they actually got one here in Boston. They made it for the TV show. Will you help?
As it happens, I already have your costume.
There she is, pretty as the posters. The Silver Shroud costume herself. And memorabilia, too? You're something else. Together with my gun, everything's all set.
What are you planning next?
I'm still working that out. Some details I want to run by you. Well, after you give me the costume, that is.
Here you go.
After all these years, the Silver Shroud is born again. But there's just one problem. I'm just not Silver Shroud material. I could be Rhett Reinhardt, or his butler, Jarvie Blake. But the Shroud is strong, capable.
Don't sell yourself short.
I got a better idea who should wear it. You up for being the Silver Shroud? You already got your own origin story and everything. What with the Cryo Vault and all.
Why me?
You helped me out when everyone else just laughed at me. And you're from the olden days, just like me. You know how much things have fallen. How much we gotta fight for. To make the place better. So you win?
Looks like I get to be the Shroud.
The costume and gun are yours. So you patrol good neighbor streets, and I'll call in any crimes on my radio station. Here's some calling cards, I guess. When you dispatch justice, leave them behind. That way, everyone knows the Silver Shroud has returned. Time to fight crime!
Hey. In the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Just a down this alley.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone got lost on the wrong side of the track.
Yeah. Wrong side of the tracks.
I'm just meeting a friend. No business of yours. Perhaps I'll just call him. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Not so fast, fancy pants. Your wallet and that snazzy briefcase you're carrying. Hand them over, now.
I most certainly will not. Do you have any idea who...
Oh, jeez, Louise. Why'd you go and do that?
'Cause he could have made us, that's why. You want to spend another stretch in the pokey? Now, let's see what's in this fancy case.
Yes?
Nothing. Papers, no cash, it's worthless. Ah, get his wallet. A suit like this has got to have something.
Ooh, enjoying yourself.
All right, let's see. $20, man. Driver's license. Oh, man, we done it this time. You know who this is? We just wasted Mayor Murphy!
What? The Mayor Murphy? What in the blazes was he doing up here? Up in Scully Square?
A mystery, to be sure.
Who said that? Show yourself.
You have murdered a man.
Calling all Silver Shroud fans. A once-in-a-lifetime announcement. The Silver Shroud returns and he's gonna clean up the streets. Everyone heard how Wayne Delancey murdered Miss Selmy and her kid over a few lousy caps. Death is coming for you, Wayne.
Galaxy News Radio.
Step away from my meat, boy.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty.
Rumor is you killed Miss Selmy.
That's true.
Selmy? Yeah, I killed the bitch. And her wealth, too. Shouldn't have bothered. They barely had two caps between them. Lights out, pal.
What?
You messed up. Reveal yourself.
Silver Shroud. Fret not, old friend. It's only me.
I guess you could call that.
Mistress of Mystery, what brings you to Scully Square on such a foul night?
Tracking our dear Mayor Murphy, who is up to some mischief.
The mayor? So he wasn't here in some kind of official capacity?
Hardly.
Friend of the show, Jerry, is here.
Is this thing on? Hello? Hello?
It's on. We're recording in here.
Aw, man.
What? Hey there.
What, you need something to take the edge off? Fred Allen, Hotel Rexford. He'll hook you up.
Great. Great. The Silver Shroud's dispatched justice already. Miss Selmy has been avenged. Shit, the Shroud off Wayne? Wait, so this guy's actually for real?
Oh, you better believe it. So, Jerry, go on. Tell the listeners about what we're talking about.
Right. So, AJ, you know the chem dealer by Bobby's. He's doing good for himself. Says he's got a whole new market. Kids. Even with his garbage chems, he's just raking in the caps.
Stay free, man.
You hear that? Sounds like a Silver Shroud has another bad guy to deal with.
Why? This Shroud guy, he's gonna muscle in on the chem trade now?
No, he's gonna do something about it. AJ's selling the kids, and his chems have killed people.
And? I don't get it.
We can't
keep
let AJ kill kids.
I can see them. Hey, you.
Whatever.
This is my turf, and I don't appreciate what you call them, you know, trespassers.
News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode in the Parlor of Mysteries.
I'm a busy guy, so can we move this along already?
Jasmine. Selling chems to kids Camomile. Is just wrong.
What's it do ya? Oh, for Christ's sake. You can't put this you up to this? He keeps moaning about the poor little kids. What the hell, right?
Shh.
Tell you what.
Be still,
I'll pay you,
sweet Trout.
Let's say, 50 caps just to shut up about
slug,
it.
But you're
and,
sick with fever
maybe get Kent off my back.
Suffering.
All right?
Mistress of Mysteries, no. I'm all right.
But last chance. No more kids.
We're shutting your ass down.
Ah, to hell with you.
No,
waste him.
The Shroud stumbled. The mistress maneuvered. I knew of the mayor's misdeeds for many days. I followed him to that fateful meeting with Fat Faye. I was about to...
Attention! Silver Shroud and Mistress of Mystery! This is Chief Corcoran of the Boston Police Department. We know you're in there. You are both wanted in connection with the murder of Mayor Murphy. Come out with your hands up!
It would seem that our leaving the scene of the Scale slaughter was terribly timed. Incurring the wrath of Boston's finest is an unfortunate and unexpected annoyance.
Unexpected by us, maybe.
The Silver Shroud's bringing justice to Good Neighbor. You bad guys better look out. And now, a special update. The villainous assassin Kendra was recently spotted at the third rail. The same Kendra who bombed Little Joe's shack and killed four innocent drifters. If you want to see the Silver Shroud in action, stay near Whitechapel Charlie. The Shroud's sure to interrogate him to find the evildoer's whereabouts.
Galaxy! News! Radio!
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Fat Fahey's Folly.
Buddy, I need to be a lot more high or a lot more drunk to be bothered
right
now.
Come on, Dollface.
Hi.
It's right through here.
Don't have no handouts.
Make way for paying customers. Want a pint, mate?
Aw, oh, gee.
You're here for Magnolia.
I
get a drink up.
I've never been in a secret gangsta hideout before.
What the? I want answers, not alcohol.
You dumb jamoke.
Tell me about Kendra.
No one learned you your P's and Q's.
It's my hideout.
Yes. Kendra is not one to be tried for. Right. People associated with her have a habit of being found face down in a ditch.
It's candy.
You're set on me.
And yeah, of course I'm all right. I'm just a young, dumb girl in love with a handsome, dangerous man.
Can you spare a few details on her, at least?
Brother.
On the house?
You got to have finesse to be an assassin.
Close that door. Last thing we need
is... Very skilled murderer. Listen, mate, the combat scan shows you know what you're about. So you can't buy a log instead.
I'm not hiring her. I'm going to kill her.
Serious? Sarcasm sometimes bungs up me processes. In that case, she's got a flat just south of Good Neighbor. Water Street Apartments.
Yeah,
for the blighters she's got with her. Nasty piece of business there. Good luck.
I have clouded Polly's paltry perceptions to gain access to your den of depravity.
Sorry, boss! I had no idea!
Your mistake is our gain, Polly, is it? Death has come for you, evildoer, and I am its shroud!
Another special update. No, it wasn't Bobby No-Nose who offed AJ and his goons. It was the Silver Shroud. See his calling card if you don't believe me. Now's our time, listeners.
Follow
Justice
me.
Justice is coming to Good Neighbor. You'll see.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That... That's all of them. Fat Fahey's mob bots have been sent back to the mechanical hell that spawned them.
Yes, my choleric companion. And no, robotic hellspawn they were. But not Fat Fahey's. For he himself presented the facts. Someone else is actually...
Master of it all. You're right. But who? Dearest Mistress of Mysteries, you and I have battled Boston's Rogues Gallery for years. This is someone new.
Certainly. But which
criminal culprit has the technological know-how to construct such clockwork calamities. I don't...
You don't know anything? Yeah, right. But I do see. And I'll tell you too. On one condition.
By the shadowed streets of Southie, one of the mob bot's heads is still talking.
You're darn right I am. I can't feel my legs, cause you shot me up good, Shroud. But I still got my kiss to see, and I'm gonna use it to tell you where the big boss man is, see?
And your one condition?
You take my head with you, so I can see you.
Follow me.
Creep down. Yeah, what are you...
Silver Shroud, I sense truth in this clockwork crook. Shall I?
Use your blade of Bastet to free the Mabot's head from its now destroyed body. Do it.
Ha! Sweet freedom! Thanks, Dormace!
Now tell us, who is your creator? The robotic puppet master pulling your twisted wires. Speak, you decapitated electronic evildoer.
That will spoil all the fun. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, let's be feet to the big warehouse down at Pier 12.
Fine, you amoral automaton. Roar away.
Can't keep a ghoul down.
Skylight. Just what we needed to stealthily infiltrate this warehouse.
Yes, and our view from above is advantageous, for the gathering below is unlike any soiree I've ever seen.
Robots. Dozens of them. All shapes and sizes. And on the stage, their leader. Another robot. No! Not a robot! A man in a robot costume!
Shh! Shut up, you dummies! Us robots got good hearing! You're gonna get yourselves caught! Now listen, boss man's about to talk!
My robotic children, my glorious creations, we stand tonight at the dawn of a new era. For too long, the human vermin of Boston have destroyed this fair city. The flesh is a gift, but steel is power. You, my children, will usher in a new age, an age of robots, led by me, your father, the Mechanist.
The Mechanist? So, evil does have a name.
Revolution begins tonight, my precious offspring. But first, let us welcome our special guests for this evening. Silver Shroud and the Mistress of Mystery.
Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one
gunman lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mechanist Unmasked.
Silver weapon of the Silver Shroud can never harm
the Silver Shroud.
So, this is the end.
How dare you live from there?
All I wanted was a better life, a better commonwealth, free from the petty squabbles of humankind.
We have the why, but not the who. Salward Shroud, unmask this miscreant and reveal the man beneath the metal.
Yes, it is time we knew the truth. Who is the Mechanist?
By the rays of Ra, the Mechanist is none other than...
Mayor Murphy! Of course, it all makes sense.
My death in that alley. A ruse. He was... just one of my robots. But by being... dead.
You could turn your little hobby into a full-time endeavor. And the real estate papers?
A rancorous ruse, a spiteful sham, all to throw us off the trail.
Yes. It was a master plan. And you ruined it all. But... what happens now? I need a doctor, an ambulance.
You okay? See any more?
Stalwart Shroud. Could it be? Can the mewling mechanist not foresee his fate?
My fate? What? Fate.
Death has come.
You must be Kendra.
You, Mayor Murphy, and I am its shroud.
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Just down this alley.
Wayne DeLance's
killer. Well, well,
I have no idea.
Looks like someone got lost on the wrong side of the track.
I do so like it when the little bug crawls willingly into the spider's web.
Wrong side of the tracks. I'm just meeting a friend. No business of
yours.
Who's
your boss?
A walking corpse like you shouldn't trouble yourself about that.
Not so fast, fancy pants. Your wallet and that snazzy briefcase you're carrying. Hand them over. Now.
I most certainly will not. Do you have any idea who... Oh, jeez Louise. Why'd you go and do that?
'Cause he could have made us, that's why. You want to spend another stretch in the pokey? Now, let's see what's in this fancy case. No cash. It's worthless. Ah! Get his wallet. A suit like this has got to have something.
All right, let's see. $20, a driver's license.
Oh, man. We done it this time. You know who this is? We just wasted Mayor Murphy!
What? The Mayor That's Murphy? It. What in the blazes was he doing up here? Up in Scully Square?
A mystery, to be sure.
Who said that? Show yourself!
You have murdered a man in cold blood. Justice must be served.
It's the Silver Shroud! Let's get out of here!
I ain't afraid of the Silver Shroud. You hear me? Come out and I'll do you like I did the mayor.
Death has come.
come for you, evildoer, and I am its shroud.
No!
My work here is done. Or is it? What brought you to Scully Square, Mayor Murphy? A journey that left you dead and Boston leaderless. Why venture? Emerge from the shadows, villain, or face the justice of the Silver Shroud!
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud!
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mystery of Mayor Murphy.
Slowly now. Reveal yourself.
Silver Shroud. Fret not, old friend. It's only me.
Mistress of Mystery, what brings you to Scully Square on such a foul night?
Tracking our dear Mayor Murphy, who is up to some mischief.
The mayor? So he wasn't here in some kind of official capacity?
Hardly. Here, let me show you the contents of the late mayor's case.
But these are real estate papers. Leases and deeds for most of the businesses in Scully Square.
Indeed they are, my intrepid investigator. It would seem our Mayor Murphy was involved in a rather crooked caper. He was here to meet with some other mysterious malefactor.
So, Mr. Mayor, I hope you found the place all... What the? Silver Shroud? And Mistress of Mystery? And the Mayor? Dead?
Right, fading, leading from his mumbles. So, you were meeting with Mayor Murphy. Why? Tell me, and you may yet live.
Just listen to my friend, Fahim.
I'll never talk. You two are in over your heads.
So be it. Death has come for you, evildoer. And I am its
Shroud. Shroud this crime fighter. Later, suckers.
Silver Shroud, you're shot.
Just a graze. You must go after him.
No. We'll let our quarry flee for now. That bullet must be removed. And you're bleeding badly.
Must get back to my...
Hush now, Stoic Shroud. I'll take you to my parlor. It is close, and that wound is worrisome.
The parlor. It's been so long.
Indeed it has, old friend. Old, long. Indeed it has. And now, we must away.
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud.
Listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode in the Parlor of Mystery.
Jasmine, chamomile,
Shroud. I removed that scumbag slug, but you're sick with fever and still suffering.
Mistress of Mysteries, no. I'm all right. But the mayor, Fat Fady, we stumbled upon a most sinister plot, old friend.
Ha! No, dear heart. The Shroud stumbled. The mistress maneuvered. I knew of the mayor's misdeeds for many days. I followed him to that fateful meeting with Fat Faye. I was about to...
Attention! Silver Shroud and Mistress of Mystery! This is Chief Corcoran of the...
Got nothing to worry about with.
Hell yeah.
Me cover.
book alive.
What do you need?
Grab that gun over there.
You got it. This beats mayoral duties any day of the week.
What's that?
We need to share some words.
Look alive.
What you got?
Hey, Hancock.
Dropping bad guys, leaving business cards. That's fun and all. But you've walked into something a whole lot bigger. Those lowlifes you've been taking out for Kenny Boy? They all belong to the same asshole. And that asshole's gonna want some good old-fashioned revenge. You dig?
That sound, what is it?
hope you realize how much you did for us.
Hey.
Time to clean him up.
What was... Something must have moved.
Hey there.
Some very bad people may be coming. It's not safe here.
I don't know you. Just go away.
Thank you.
This is gonna hurt!
My kind of trouble.
Thank you.
from there now.
A little something to take the edge off.
Thank you. We need to share some words.
Hey.
Hmm? Dropping bad guys, leaving business cards. That's fun and all. But you've walked into something a whole lot bigger. Those lowlifes you've been taking out for Kenny Boy? They all belong to the same asshole. And that asshole's gonna want some good old-fashioned revenge. You dig?
Brother, I've lost track of how many people want me dead.
Yeah, but this guy has the means to do it. His name's Sinjin. He's taken 2-bit raider outfits and made them... scary. Small fish now, but if left alone... I happen to know where some of his other boys are. Smiling Kate operates outside of Bunker Hill. And Northy's got a pad over at Prospect Hill. You take them out, and maybe we can find out where the big guy himself is stashed. Good neighbor'd rest a whole lot easier with him out of the picture.
I'm up for some community service.
You know, you're all right. You take care of Sinjin, and I'm inclined to show some gratitude. You feel me?
Fatality.
Hi.
If it isn't the boy behind the costume. You've been really naughty, Mr. Shroud. Making all my friends so nervous with your calling cards. Taking out St. John's favorite toy soldiers. But now it's time to rip your goddamned heart out!
That was easy.
Hey.
get some, motherfucker! Please.
There is no mercy.
Kendra and Delancey are 6 feet under. The Silver Shroud claim the hits. Northy, Sinjin wants you to keep up the recruiting efforts. We need more warm bodies after we deal with the costume. And don't worry, Kate's gathering a bunch of meatheads to take the Shroud out. The boss ain't happy. Now's not a time for failure. He's getting personal tomorrow. He's gonna pay the Shroud's funky friend a special visit in Goodnigger. After he's done with that, he'll check in. He'll expect results.
Thank you.
Hold up a sec.
We got a good supply of clean water. Things would be pretty good.
Last time we talked, I hope I didn't bore you to death by dumping my life story on you.
I always have time for new buddies.
hope you realize how much you did for us.
Can't remember the last time I had clean fingernails.
I like to collect Bob. What? They're really cute.
Hey.
Don't ask questions. That's a good name. Better for everyone.
Oh, it's you. Oh, Sugar. I told Kent all that hero stuff was going to get you both killed. God. Oh, God.
What happened to Kent? Where is he?
They took him. Raiders. Nothing but bloodlust in their eyes. We couldn't stop them. When they took him away, they left you a message. Just listen to Kent's radio station. It keeps playing it over and over again.
Yeah?
it, Shroud! Do it! Oh, my knee! Ah.
Tick-tock, Shroud. Don't keep me waiting. We got business that needs finishing.
Here's a Silver Shroud update. In case you missed it, Kendra's reign of terror is over. She won't be... What? Oh, God! What's happening?
On your knees, dirtbag!
What? What are you doing? What? Ah!
You got some serious damage on your face around here, Mayor.
Well, look who it is.
This is the Shroud's headquarters.
Always did have a big
so you must be the Silver Shroud's little friend.
Some spine. Yes. Make the first move. I didn't.
If you want to see your friend alive, Shroud,
here before you get yourself
meet me at Milton
hurt.
General Hospital.
Don't do it, Shroud. It's a trap. Save yourself. Ah! Ah! Oh my God! Do it, Shroud. Do it. Oh, my knee. Ah.
Tick-tock, Shroud. Don't keep me waiting. We got business that needs finishing.
Here's a Silver Shroud update. In case you missed it, Kendra's reign of terror is over. She won't be... What? Oh, God! What's happening?
On your knees, dirtbag!
What? What are you doing? What? Ah!
Sinjin, all clear.
This is the Shroud's headquarters. So...
Yes?
If you want to see your friend alive, Shroud, meet me at Milton General Hospital.
Don't do it, Shroud. It's a trap. Save yourself.
This is just the waiting room? Guess there was real money in the suffering of others.
Hey, I got something.
Well, it certainly puts a new spin on cleaning up the Commonwealth, don't it?
Thank you.
weed. Got it.
Thank you. What the hell was that?
I want to talk with you!
Huh?
Hold position.
Hold, assholes. Anyone turns heel, I'm coming for you and your family. And you, Shroud. You step any closer, and we get to see what's inside Ken's head.
What do you want, Sinjin?
We'll get to that. Some of these losers are still waiting for the legendary Silver Shroud. They think the Shroud walks straight out of a comic book. But you and I know. The Shroud's just you in a stupid, flea-ridden costume. You're weak. You came here. And for what? Your little sidekick?
Friends don't make you weak. They make you strong.
I can play you like a chump because you care about a weakling like this. And you think that's strength? So what's gonna happen is this. I'm going to kill Kent. Then we're gonna shoot the hell out of you. Nothing's gonna be left but paste. Then, I'm going to Good Neighbor and kill every last worthless bastard there and burn the whole thing down. No one screws with Sinjin. Life.
What happens is this. Everyone that points a gun at me dies. Every last one.
Jesus. Sinjin can't do anything to us if he's dead.
Cowards! Cowards!
This ain't gonna take long.
I've never been so happy to see anyone in my entire life.
That was close.
I thought I was done for. For sure. I just give up. On all of it. Crime fighting just isn't what I thought it'd be.
Really? After all this, you're just giving up?
I knew it was bad out there. But this? I don't even think the Silver Shroud himself could fix this disaster area.
If you just quit, then the bad guys have already won.
You're right. But I'm tired. I just want to go home. I'm going back to Good Neighbor. Really, thanks for saving me. But I'm just done.
The Shroud's real! Real, I tell ya!
Hey there.
I don't want to die. Just let us live.
Hi.
I never wanted to work for Sinjin.
Hi.
Huh? Hey.
Just say the... So down goes the big bad Sinjin. We get to walk that tightrope of freedom one more day. Take this for the effort.
The world's better without him.
And the future looks a little brighter. Gutter's been running a little too red lately. You keep them clean, and you're welcome back anytime.
Follow me.
Never trip alone.
Ground floor.
Hey there.